महारानी अहिल्याबाई होलकर इन लैटर डेज फ्रॉम ब्रह्मा केम इन लैटर डेज फ्रॉम ब्रह्मा केम टू रूल अवर लैंड अ नोबल डेम काइंड वॉज हर हर्ट एंड ब्राइट हर फेम अहिल्या वॉज हर ऑनर्ड नेम अहिल्या वॉज हर ऑनर्ड नेम राइट्स पोएट जोना बेली इन 1849 इन ऑनर ऑफ वन ऑफ द ग्रेटेस्ट मराठा वुमन रूलर्स ऑफ मालवा बॉर्न इन द विलेज ऑफ चौंडी इन जामखेड अहमदनगर महारानी अहिल्याबाई और एज शी वॉज फॉन्डली रेफर्ड टू राजमाता अहिल्याबाई होलकर वॉज द होलकर क्वीन ऑफ द मालवा किंगडम हर फादर मानकोजीराव शिंदे वॉज द पाटिल ऑफ द विलेज In spite of women's education being a far cry in the village, her father homeschooled her to read and write. While Ahilya did not come from a royal lineage, most deem her entry into history a twist of fate. It dates back when the acclaimed lord of the Malwa territory, Malhara Holkar, spotted an 8-year-old Ahilyabai at the temple service feeding the hungry and poor on his stop in Chaundi while traveling to Pune. Moved by the young girl's charity and strength of character, he decided to ask her hand in marriage for his son Khanderao Holkar. She was married to Khanderao Holkar in 1733. At the tender age of 8. But the distress was quick to befall the young bride when her husband Khanderao was killed in the Battle of Kumbher in 1754, leaving her a widow at only 29. When Ahilyabai was about to commit sati, her father-in-law Malhar Rao refused to let it happen. He had been her strongest pillar of support at the time. But a young Ahilyabai could see her kingdom fall like a pack of cards after her father-in-law passed away in 1766, only 12 years after the death of his son Khanderao. The old ruler's death led to his grandson and Ahilyabai's only son Malerao Holkar ascending the throne under her regency. The last strike came when the young monarch Malerao II died a few months into his rule on 5th April 1766, thus creating a vacuum in the power structure of the kingdom. One can imagine how a woman, royalty or not, would suffer after losing her husband, father-in-law and only son. But Ahilyabai stood undeterred. She did not let the grief of her loss affect the administration of the kingdom and the lives of her people. She took matters into her own hands. She petitioned the Peshwa after the son's death to take over the administration herself. She ascended the throne and became the ruler of Indore on 11th December 1767. While there was indeed a section of the kingdom that objected to her assumption to the throne. Her army of Holkars stood by her and supported their queen's leadership. Just a year into her rule, one saw the brave Holkar queen protect her kingdom, fighting off invaders tooth and nail from plundering Malwa. Armed with swords and weapons, she led armies into the battlefield. There she was the queen of Malwa, slaying her enemies and invaders on battlefronts with four bows and quivers of arrows fitted to the corners of the howdha of her favorite elephant. Her confidante on military matters was Subedar Tukoji Holkar, also Malhar Rao's adopted son, whom she appointed the head of the military. The Queen of Malwa, apart from being a brave queen and proficient ruler, was also an erudite politician. She observed the bigger picture when the Maratha Peshwa couldn't pin down the agenda of the British. In her letter to the Peshwa in 1772, she had warned him, calling the British embrace as bear hug. other beasts like tigers can be killed by might or contrivance, but to kill a bear it is very difficult. It will die only if you kill it straight in the face, or else once caught in its powerful hold, the bear will kill its prey by tickling. Such is the way of the English. And given this, it is difficult to triumph over them. Thank you.